An accused killer's final moments of freedom, Beau Lamar arrives at his uncle's Grays Point home this morning. The pair leave soon after, headed to Bondi Police Station, where the 28-year-old handed himself in. He's now charged with killing his ex-boyfriend, Jesse Baird, and Baird's new partner, Luke Davies.
We believe that the fate of both Luke and Jesse was at the house of Pannington.
TV presenter Baird and Qantas flight attendant Davies were last seen on Sunday night. The police officer allegedly shot both men on Monday using his police-issued handgun.
We found a projectile and a fired cartridge case which matches a police firearm.
He too disappeared and a major manhunt unfolded, with investigators searching for his white van, which was seen outside Baird's home on Monday night.
The 28-year-old man facing these charges was in a relationship with Jesse some time ago, which finished.
This saga spanned the entire city and up the coast. It started in Cronulla with bloodied clothes discovered in a skip bin. That led police to the scene in Paddington and a unit in Waterloo and a townhouse in Balmain. Police confirmed Lamar also made his way up to Newcastle before returning to Grays Point. The white van was discovered this morning around 300 metres from where the accused officer met with family here in Grays Point. This street has now been declared a crime scene and the vehicle will be taken for testing.
At some stage, the white van was used to transport their bodies to another location. That's why we're keen to find where that location is.
Overnight, officers pulled apart his Balmain home, which he shares with his parents. He wasn't there, but mountains of potential evidence were taken away. Before joining the police force, the accused killer was a well-known celebrity chaser and made headlines for this aggressive taser attack in Paddington 4 years ago.
Get on the ground, put your hands out!
Now he's accused of far worse and refusing to say where he allegedly dumped the bodies.
It's really important that we do locate the bodies, not only for the cause of death, but also for the answers for the family.
The home here in Paddington remains one of several active crime scenes tonight, with police still looking for those bodies. It's just been revealed the accused officer confided in someone after the killings, and that person is right now speaking with detectives. They're hoping that information will provide some much-needed answers for the victims' families.